Hey guys, guess what? This just arrived yesterday. Finally, after a long wait, I can unbox for you the T2 Cruza. So it says here the package is about 3 kilograms, and the box itself, it's like 60 centimeter by 39 and 22. It's a rather large box. I was planning on keeping the plane inside when I'm not using it. But let's jump straight into it. So it looks like we have some paperwork. And inside we have 3 separate compartments, it looks like. Let's try to get them out. Awesome. Okay. Let's start with the smaller box. So it looks like all of them open up on the end. Uh-huh. So I think we have the body here, and that's it. And this is the famous removable nose. That looks nice. The foam, it's like very light, but strong, quite strong. And the walls, like, they almost have no flex in them. And yeah, we have the black PCB now. Can you see inside? Okay, I guess you can. Awesome. So the body itself, it's kind of like, what did I do? I put the nose backwards. Yes, of course I did. So the body itself, it's like 57 by 13 and a half centimeters. And for the batteries, you have 8.5 centimeter by, let's see, about 17 centimeter, I would say. That's huge, huge, huge. Okay, great. Let's see the middle box. What do we have here? Lots of goodies. Okay. So we have props, which are 80-55. Okay. And they look very tough. Yeah. So this is this front part. Yeah. So I think it fits quite well. This is the horizontal stabilizer. It's quite stiff out of the box, I would say. Doesn't flex too much with the 2 servos. Let's see. And the vertical stabilizer. Aha, so this is now like a tube. Not sure if it's any different from what was before, but it clicks nicely into place and it swivels. It doesn't freely like swing about, it has some resistance to it. Maybe that's intentional. Aha, so that's great, that's just great. Actually, you know what? Let's leave it plugged in. Just so we will have an idea about how the plane looks. And this looks like it is the tail boom. So here we have the tail boom. I have to figure out which end goes where. let's see. So if you take a look at the connector, it's quite simple to figure this one out. Yeah, and it clicks into place and it doesn't rotate after you click it into place. So now I'm connecting the tail boom to the body. Okay. Yeah, that's not hard to do at all. That's not hard to do at all. We have the props. Oh, this is the second part that goes here. Yeah. Awesome. And now we have some bag of goodies. So this is the engine, the motor propeller adapters. This is a really, really tiny fan. It's like smallest I have ever seen. It's like 25 millimeter fan. Yeah. These are the covers and the plastic parts that contain it. These are some wooden parts to mount the battery and some braces. You get like a bag of screws, like really, really tiny screws. This is a bag of control arms and servo arms and really, really tiny control arms, push rods, sorry. And we do have an aluminium part for the tail servo. You can see that, but we will get it out of the bag and I will have a close-up for you. And oh, that's really great. So it looks like my gift was the flaps servos, because these are not coming in the package by default. And the last bag here, it's the two carbon fiber spars. Great. That's great. And the last box. And the last box, let's see. Yep. Awesome. Okay. So we have here the wings. It looks like we have some servos already installed. The motors are already installed, and the motors are Sunny Sky 2216. Minus 12, whatever that is, and it's 730 kV. Oh, that's very good for 6X, 6S, I hope. This is the ailerons. Servo, it doesn't look to be glued in. Maybe I'm wrong. I kind of like these covers. I was imagining that they are not staying in place so securely, but they definitely do. And anyway, you can put some tape over it if you like doing that. Oh, this is the, let's say, GPS or video transmitter or radio receiver space. And this should be the place where, yeah, here I can mount the flap servos, which I will do, definitely. I was hoping to get bigger motor somehow, but it's probably fine. Yeah. So right, let's mount the wings. Just to have an idea how the whole thing will look like. I better put the spars in first. Okay, so the spars go. So the spars go into the plastic holes right there. Into the wing they go a little bit with a better fit. Okay, I reached the end. And So I should be able to lock these in place. But actually, I have to push the wing a little bit. Okay. Oh, that's nice. Firm click to reassure you that you did it well. I don't know why the spars are like, one is bigger than the other, maybe. No, they are the same size. Okay, let me try again. Yeah, that's it. And the second one. Okay, now it's all better. And the second wing. Okay. Okay, awesome. So if we put this back, this is it basically. Doesn't take much to assemble it at all, and it's like a huge plane when you do assemble it, when you finish it. Take a look at this bird. I just figured out what these two things here are. These are the skids that I can glue here. And this is it. This is it basically. Awesome, awesome. So my plan is to use the crossfire system for remote control. It's been serving me very, very well. For the GPS, I will have M10 Goku GPS receiver and compass. This will go right here. I also have a pitot tube for the airspeed sensor, and for the flight controller I will use the new SpeedyB 405 wing. So this will be my flight controller. And I plan to use the iNav but also the ArduPilot. Okay, so that's my plan. If you would like to see the next video where I do the wiring for all the electronics, you can subscribe and YouTube will let you know when the video comes out. Okay, so here we can have a close-up of the small bags that we have. So this is T2 hatch parts. Oh, these are very light. These are very light. So these will go here and to the port on the back for the GPS. And this is the clamp that will go here. Like so. And this is the other side that comes on the inside. This is T2 horns and accessories. Okay. We will have to mount this on the tail boom. These are really nice control horns and push rods. They are like slightly translucent but pretty dark. I think they're nylon. And it looks like you have to mount the control arms and the linkages with screws, which is really nice. Yeah. I'll have to figure out where the screws go. These are two servos for the flaps and some extension wires, it looks like. Okay. Yeah, I'll have to figure out what this extension does. These look like 9 gram servos, but maybe they are 12 or 15. They look a little bit more heavy. Does it say on the box? No. This, oh, you get a battery strap, which looks to be very, very solid. This is like much stronger than the ones I have on my drones. Laser cut wooden parts. Let's see. Okay, so we have two braces. These are really not like for mechanical resistance, it's more to protect the wires. Oh, I think this goes in the nose to hold the fan. This is a battery strap for sure, because you mount it inside like this, and then the battery strap will go like that on those two holes. Actually, we can kind of mount it, so it will be easy to lock the battery down. And this is another wooden panel, probably to protect the PDB board. Next we have a bag labeled T2 propeller mounting base. So these are the same, and it's just allowing you to mount the propellers on the motors, because the motors don't have a shaft like the drone motors have. I would have preferred that, actually. This looks a little bit smaller than a 5 mm shaft, but we will have to see. So this will mount right here with the 3 screws, and then you can mount the propellers, which fit absolutely perfect. There's like no play, which is really nice. And you also get a pressure plate, I guess. Yeah. And this nut is, yeah, it sounds like hardened steel on the aluminum. I don't know how good of an idea is that, but okay. Or you can also use the spinner that they give you. That's cool. That's really nice. Okay. This is the bag of small screws for mounting the wooden battery plate and the braces. This is a small fan, and you do get some sticky pads for some reason. So this is flap fix double-sided sticker. Aha, so in case you're not using the flaps, I guess the idea is to glue it in place. I wouldn't do it like this, because then it would be really hard to go back to having flaps. I will just put some tape over it. And yeah, this is some cheap fan, I guess. And of course we have these skids. One of them came a little bit bent, but I don't think that's a huge problem. And they look to be very, very slippery. So I think this is some nice Teflon. And they do have a curve to it, so you have to be careful which ones you install where. I think I'm gonna mount at least one motor just to see how it is. So we will use the blue spinner prop adapter thing. I'm gonna take everything off of it. They will need the 3 black screws that come in a separate bag. And these are, okay, so these are hex screws, so you will need an appropriate screwdriver for that. Yeah, it's a good idea to put some wax on these screws, or maybe some Loctite. Don't go tight on the first round, just get them close. I heard that's a good idea. Okay. The reason why I'm doing this, I'm really curious to see if with the props on, If you do a belly landing, the props are gonna hit the ground. Yes, then it looks like they will. Oh, that's really nice on the wing tips. You do get the new type of LED. That's really cool. A quick note about the tail boom section. So if you take a look here, you have three exposed contacts and they actually protrude a little bit. So I would highly recommend to keep the end caps. So don't throw these away. Yeah. They will protect the tube from getting the dust inside and also not to bend those contacts. Another note about the hatch in the nose, this piece of plastic here, you might think you can mount it both ways, but this is actually not a square. It may look like a square because of perspective, but if you try to mount the hatch the other way around, you cannot. So it only goes one way. If you don't want to use it, I guess you can easily 3D print a piece of plastic that will go there. I will actually design one just in case I want to have some other type of camera mounting. Definitely I want to put a GoPro Session 5 on this, so be on the lookout for my next video where I will also post the links to the Thingiverse files. And about the hatch in the back, I will mount a GPS unit in there, and the one that I chose is a Goku M10. Yeah. So make sure when you mount it that the antenna is facing up, okay? And the nice thing is that this particular model fits the space perfectly. Yeah. And most likely if you use this type of hatch on top of it, it's not gonna affect the signal too much. But you should definitely test this before you glue it permanently in. So remember the piece of paper that we saw in the beginning? Actually, on the back you do have some schematics about how to assemble it. You don't have to figure it out if you don't want to. Like, I usually enjoy figuring stuff out like that. But this is great. This is great. I wouldn't throw this away, even if I'm not planning on using it. And it looks like mounting the control arms for the elevators. It's pretty simple. So the piece of plastic goes like this on the inside. On the, sorry, top part, and on the other side you have, and on the other side you have a corresponding piece of plastic that is fixed in place with a screw. So on the tail section here, I don't know why this doesn't come already assembled, but you need to mount the aluminium part, the red aluminium part, right there, right? And there is actually a sign on the plastic to tell you where the center is. And you have to also put a small screw here to tighten the servo arm to the servo. This is a metal gear servo. And then you have a little bigger screw that secures on top, but this is a Phillips screw. So the bigger screw will go like here. And I'm not going to put Loctite on this because I know that sometimes you do need to get to it after the fact. I'm actually going to fix it in place with the top screw, and then I'm gonna tighten the arm around the servo arm, around the servo shaft, with the hex screw. And then I'm gonna fix the arm, the servo arm, in place with the included screw. One note, never use Loctite for the screws that touch the plastic parts, because with time the Loctite's chemical will kind of dissolve the plastic and they will crack, and yeah, you don't want that. So next I'm gonna mount the push rod, the control rod, in the servo arm with the Z-bend in the servo arm. And next I'm gonna take a linkage and simply screw it in the control rod. And I'm going to try to do this in a way that, and I'm going to try to align it perfectly so the elevator is flat when the servo is dead center. Okay, and the last step, after you found the perfect linkage distance, yeah, the holes align and the servo is right in the middle, you can use the M2x8 screws. M2x8 screws, they look a little bit different. So they're not threaded all the way. This is because you don't want friction where the movement of the pivot happens. So these don't need to be tight, obviously.